Third question. Let's start. Hello, everyone. Welcome to eCommit 2020. My name is Ms. Domerin Adolfo. I'm a faculty member of the Far Eastern University under Institute of Education. So welcome to our 2000 eCommit again. Okay, so for the meantime, as we are waiting for the others to enter and to join, please see, guys, the Padlet link there that I posted. Please kindly create your business card or calling card. You may use the chat box and the Padlet as well. I hope everyone can hear me. Okay. Okay, good afternoon again. So let's discuss first the following house rules as we have our socialization for today. So please write your questions, answers, and discussion and thoughts in the Padlet and in the chat box. So feel free to do that. And observe the turn taking for the Q&A and sharing of thoughts and ideas. And participants have to wait for the facilitator to acknowledge them to speak and share ideas. So we can start. I am going to share my screen. Okay, so welcome again, everyone. So this is the virtual room one for the graduate school faculty. My name is Domerin Adolfo. I'm your moderator for today. So here are socialization guidelines. So again, everyone is encouraged to share and participate. Turn taking will be observed. So you can use the raise hand button of Zoom and wait for the moderator to call you. You may also share your questions and insights in the chat box and in the Padlet link below. It's also in your chat box. So again, we are calling people here. Guys, hello. Okay, you may want to introduce yourself. You may want to turn on your audio and introduce yourself and give a little about yourself. Am I going to call you one by one? Is that okay? Okay, so hello, sir. Let's have maybe Christian, Mr. Christian Alec Borja. So you're the first one to enter the virtual room. Can we hear you? Okay, hello, sir Christian. Okay. Ms. Rosemary, are you there? Hi. Okay. Maybe Ms. Chini can do it first. Ms. Chini?
Hi. Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yes, Madam Domeline. Okay, so I'd like to greet everyone pleasant afternoon, especially Dr. Isa, who is also with us this afternoon. So thank you, Sir Christian Borja, Sir Christian Evasco also. And you also have Ma'am Regine and Ma'am Rosemary around. And hopefully we'll have also other participants later. But this will be interesting as this can be a very intimate discussion. So I'm looking forward to having something tangible after this session. I hope to be able to have collaborations with you because I am currently affiliated with FEU Graduate Studies. And I'm currently the department chair next to Dr. Isa, who is also with us, but is now sitting as our director for quality assurance. And I'm very happy because she would join us also to share about the future directions of the graduate programs and what awaits us, especially now that we have changed the scheme from regular face-to-face program offerings to hybrid or blended type of learning. So what awaits us, what threatens us, or maybe what are the things that can unfold and what possible partnerships we can develop after this session. So you can call me Chini. I think you're already seeing my business card in Padlet if you've already tried the link, or you can just visit our website www.feu.edu.ph. okay, yan, baka magalit si Sir Christian, mali ang aking ano, www.feu.edu.ph. and I think you're also seeing me as one of the recipients of the email sent to you for eCommit 2020. So thank you again for participating. I'm giving the floor now back to you, Ma'am Dom.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Chini. Okay, and of course, another pride of FEU is Ms. Isa. Hi there, Ms. Isa.
Hello, Ma'am Dom. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. I really don't know what to expect in this afternoon session, but I'm very much excited as to like what Dr. Chini is saying as to what will be unfolding in this afternoon's discussion. So I will just sit here and relax and will enjoy the session with you. Good afternoon and nice meeting you all.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Isa. Okay. And who wants to volunteer to introduce yourself? Okay, maybe can you hear me, Sir Christian and Miss Rosemary and Miss Regine? Can you hear me? Okay, so yes, people are still coming, and please join us today for today's event. Okay, Miss Chini, maybe we can start first the conversation as we are waiting for the others to get in. Miss Chini, I know you're always there.
I'm everywhere.
Yeah, you're everywhere.
Yeah, I think my role right now is to ask our other participants to unmute so that we can keep this alive. I would also like to acknowledge, I think we are having more participants around. We have Ma'am Melissa from Sacred Heart College, and we also have Sir Vicente. Maybe we can hear from Ma'am Melissa if it's okay, if she's not busy with her in her workplace. Maybe just a word or two.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Chini, for inviting me.
Hi, Miss Melissa.
Hello.
Yeah, would you like to introduce yourself?
wait, shall I turn on my camera?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, hi. Right now I'm in my office. So, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Melissa Carrillo. I am from Sacred Heart College, and I am the English Era Coordinator of my school.
Yes.
And thank you, Dr. Chini, for inviting me.
Yes. Welcome, Ms. Melissa, to eCommer. Okay. And then maybe we can hear from Sir Vicente Mangilaya. Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can actually hear you.
Hi.
Yeah, you can call me Sir Mary. And actually, I feel stupid right now.
portals and index journals. And I also provided you a very good review on my capabilities. I hope you will like it. And sir, this is it from my side. And I would like you to help me and guide me when will be my paper presentation date and in what timing. Thank you very much.
Okay. By the way, Sir Angelo is here. One of the... Yes, sir. Sir Angelo. Acknowledging Sir Angelo. One of the organizers of this conference. Maybe just in case if you have questions about conference, about schedule, or maybe technical aspects of this event, we can refer to him. Thank you so much, Sir Angelo, for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you.
Hello, sir. Hello. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Thank you so much,
Thank
sir.
Thank you.
Very diverse research interest. Okay, let's have another one.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, so, ma'am.
Standardisado.
Okay. My name Bilang is Abad from Jose Rizal Memorial State University, College of Nursing and Allied Health Sciences. Areas of interest is more on health as well as social science. And then my recent publication is the Alternative Learning System Program Implementation Landscape Through the Lens of the Support Mechanism to Instruction, Teachers' Attitude and Best Practices. Okay, so I hope to have collaborations also among these teachers here that are enthusiasts of research also. Thank you very much.
Okay, so those with research interest in line with Ma'am Grace, you can check her details later in the Padlet. Okay. By the way, those who have just come in this meeting, please click the link I sent in the chat box. It's the Padlet. It's where you can type some of your comments or maybe questions, reflections. You may also type your details or even upload your business card. So if other participants would want to collaborate with you or work with you in the future, they can use the information uploaded in the Padlet. Okay, thank you, ma'am. Let's have another one. Feel free to unmute. Okay. Let's have, I'm not sure if Ma'am or Sir Hayamira. Ah, Ma'am Hayamira. I sorry. It's or anyone. Who wants to volunteer? Or I'll volunteer you. Okay, can we have Ma'am Rose Alvarez this time? Rose Ann Alvarez. Are you there, Ma'am Rose? Okay, or maybe let's have, how about Ma'am Elmira? Ma'am Elmira Rodriguez.
Hello po, sir.
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Hello, everyone. My name is Elmira C. Rodriguez from Jose Rizal Memorial State University. Actually, I am new to this field of research, and what I will be presenting by on Friday is my master's thesis. I hope I could learn from the experts. I hope I could learn from all of you both. Thank you.
We have lots of experts in the group. Surely we will learn a lot from them later. By the way, what subject do you teach, ma'am?
I I teach mostly English as subjects po, sir. So my research interest is more on linguistics, and hopefully I could work on research such as on phonetics and phonology, but I have not yet started po. Hopefully soon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, po, sir.
Okay. How about Sir Justin kaya? Sir Justin Mel. Sir Justin, are you there? Oh, maybe let's go back to Sir Justin later. Let's have another one. How about Sir Vicente? Sir Vicente Marie.
Yeah, hello. Can I opt not to open my camera?
Okay lang po, sir. Okay. No problem.
Hello, I'm Mr. Mary. I am currently a graduate school student from the Philippine Normal University. I'm currently taking up Master of Arts in English Language Education. I'm also a neophyte in the field of research. I only had two opportunities to present my previous researches. One was in a national conference organized by the Philippine Normal University last of February of last year, as far as I could remember, and also a conference organized by the Education University of Hong Kong. For this year, I actually had the opportunity to have one research published I think it's not a Scopus-based research journal, but it's an international journal based in Indonesia. So I actually do not know the reason why I entered this room, because I'm supposed to be probably in another room, but I opted to enter this room because I would like to hear some expert advice from other people here, because I know that I'm going to learn a lot from you guys, especially that right now I'm actually in the last subject of for my academic requirements, seminar and thesis writing. So I'm probably can learn
dahil
from
naman, sabi niya,
your knowledge and at wisdom on how to conduct better research. So maybe that's it. Thank you, sir.
I think you're in the right room. We have lots of research experts in this meeting at the moment, so surely we can learn a lot from them later.
Thank you.
Let's have, or maybe last three, because we still have topics to discuss. Maybe let's just call last three participants to introduce themselves, or maybe you can volunteer. Anyone, feel free to unmute your microphone. Hello, Ma'am Marife.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon,
Hi,
ma'am.
Sir Greg. Good afternoon. I'm Marife Madrista Napaliaton. I'm presently connected at Jose Rizal Memorial State University, Tampilisan Campus. And I think it's mga third time or fourth time ko na to na nag-a-attend ako ng mga ganitong conferences, but in your case, this is my first time to attend, since it's first international, right, Sir Greg?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I already published, I think, two papers in GPAIR journal, but it's not in line with my specialization because I am a BS Ed major in English. So right now, I'm only participant in this conference. I hope not to present any paper I have also my presentation on Friday in Royal Institute of Singapore, or II. That is why I opted to be a participant in this conference. And it's advantage on my part also that I am in this room because I'm about to start my master's thesis soon. So I hope I learn a lot from this conference. And I think that's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Maripe. By the way, what's your subject? What subjects subject do you teach?
I'm handling mostly PED subjects. Sorry, it's professional education subjects. Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Looking forward to be
thank you also, sir.
Sitting in one of your presentations in the future.
Yeah.
Or soon.
Soon, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Maybe last two. Okay lang ba? Unless some will volunteer later. How about Ma'am Regine Obvious? Ma'am Regine, are you here?
Kajo-join ko lang po. Sorry po.
Okay. Or maybe we can go back to Ma'am Regine later. I can see Sir Romualdo Mabuan in the group. Sir Romualdo, can you share something? Or maybe let's just go back to Sir Romualdo later. How about you? Or any volunteer, feel free to unmute. Wala na. Okay. Or maybe let's proceed to the first question. Okay, question, what is the current status or current research status of your university or your institution? Like for example, before in hiring faculty, schools and universities usually just concentrate on the academic background of the applicant. But now they are looking for three qualifications. Aside from academic and teaching experience, they also look at the impact of the applicant in the community. They look at the extension program or outreach activities the applicant participated in. And aside from these two, very importantly, they consider research. Okay, like for example, in FEU, one of the requirements for accepting or hiring faculty members is publication. Okay, faculty members must be, or applicants must be, must have publications for them to be accepted in the university. That's one. How about in your university? What is the current situation? Or in your institution, what is the current research situation? Anyone? Sir Gerson, go ahead. Yes, Sir Gerson. Okay, maybe let's just go back to Sir Gerson later. How about the others? Sinong pwede mag-share? Ma'am Carla, do you want to share something? Yes, Ma'am Carla, you're acknowledged. Go ahead
po. I would like to introduce yes, thank you so much. Hello po, I'm Carla Gavion from the Mariano Marcos State University here in Ilocos Norte. And what I can observe is that research is not really that much looked into when it comes to hiring faculty, but it's just plus points kind of when it comes to research, but it's not really required for the institution to hire someone if they have research or not. And sir, if it's okay, can I introduce myself to
everyone? Sure, ma'am, go ahead. Go ahead.
I was trying to connect a while ago, but I didn't have proper internet connection. Okay. Hello, everyone. I am Carla, and I am... Sir Gerson is saying something. I can continue?
Sorry, yes, sorry.
Go ahead, continue.
It's okay, sir. I'm fairly new in the academe. I only have 2 years under my belt. And
okay. Nag-freeze si ma'am. Hello, ma'am. Or maybe let's just go back to ma'am Carla later. Okay, let's go back to ma'am later. How about the others? What is the current research situation of your institution or your university at the moment?
Permission to speak po.
Yes, Sir Gerson, you're acknowledged. Go ahead po.
Okay, good afternoon po. I'm Sir Gerson Hulo from DepEd Quezon, specifically Castañas National High School in Sariaya, Quezon. So in DepEd, as for entry level, applying for Teacher 1 position, research paper or researches is not a mandatory for entry level. But for applying for promotion, let's say for master teacher, for teacher two, writing a research should be a requirement and it will be given a certain point by the promotional team. That's all po, thank you.
Okay, thank you sir, so much, Sir Gerson. How about the others? Ma'am Carla, do you want to share? Ma'am Carla Marie?
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon,
my name is Carla Reddy Curanila. IC school head of Quezon Science High School. So now you're asking how is the research culture in our school. So this is very timely because the paper that I'm going to present tomorrow is entitled The Junior and High School Teachers' Motivation and Reservation in Immersing into the Culture of Research. If you're going to ask me as of this moment how many teachers under my care are doing research, I have 22 teachers, but only 4 of them engage in the research. Sir Gerson on the right, some of the teachers, especially in DepEd, conducted their research for promotion processes, sorry to say. But according to this, positively teachers said, sabi nila, they...
Ma'am, nakamute ka ata. Namute ka, ma'am.
Anyway, so the motivation of the teachers, they said they will become effective teacher if they conducted a research or an action research on their subjects. Those are the high school and the senior high school teachers, junior high school teachers. They also revealed that somewhat research gives them a sense of fulfillment. And I do believe if you are a researcher, it's not just you want to prove something, but you see a fulfillment in doing research. So I encourage my teachers to conduct research, not just to have this qualification for their promotion or to use the paper for the promotion, but nonetheless conducting research will make them effective teachers because they're going to see what will be the result of the studies that they are going through. That's it. Thank you.
Because we can claim about anything, but it only becomes valid if it's supported by fact. It's supported by research. Exactly. And research can really help us prove whatever arguments or opinions we have about different issues. Thank you so much, Ma'am Carla. Maybe let's have another one.
Sir Greg?
Yes, sir. Sir Mon, go ahead.
Yes. Sir Greg, I'm currently teaching at Pangasinan State University School of Advanced Studies. So I'm teaching MAED and PhD classes. So last year, CHED released their CMO or CHED Memorandum Order number 15 series 2019. That is actually the policy standards and guidelines for graduate programs in the Philippines. Now, universities are being forced by CHED to ask, not just to ask, but to force students before they graduate to publish one article in a refereed journal. So we are now in a transition period. Our transition period is from 2020 to 2024. So all universities under CHED in the future will have this CMO in their belt. So everyone doing their graduate programs or doing their graduate studies will be forced to publish in a refereed journal. Now, the problem, Sir Greg, is that some universities, they're establishing their own journal. Now, they're asking students or graduating students to publish their articles in these journals. The problem is these students would want to use their publication in the future, for example, a promotion. So it says here in the CMO from CHED that it's just a refereed journal. But for teachers, like DepEd teachers and university teachers to get promoted, they should at least publish their works in Scopus or WOS or Web of Science index journals. So that becomes the problem now. Mm-hmm. Because I think the CMO number 15 might have forgotten to put there what kind of a refereed journal they're referring to, because it's just refereed journal. Are they referring to refereed journal suggested by CHED or refereed journal under Scopus or Web of Science?
That's actually one of the problems, especially to journal just beginning. Because researchers, according to them, they've exerted lots of effort, time, in conducting the research, and that they want to publish it in, for example, Scopus or refereed journals. So they try, parang they look at the current status of the publication. Kung hindi pa siya refereed, usually they don't publish. That's actually one of the challenges.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much, Sir Mon.
In addition, Sir Greg,
yes, Sir Mon.
One more thing. Because of the CMO number 15, the university actually, I'm sorry if I'll use the word sacked, all professors or teachers teaching thesis writing who got no published articles. So now all professors or instructors teaching thesis writing are all published professors or instructors.
That's actually another issue. Okay. Any thoughts about what Sir Mon has just raised?
Hi, Sir Greg. Good afternoon.
Yes, Ma'am Donabel. Go ahead po.
This is Donabel. Central office. Actually, I agree with that notion given by Sir Mon. At present, I am also connected with Emilio Aguinaldo College, mm-hmm. and I am pursuing my doctoral degree. And actually, they are really encouraging, not encouraging, they're actually pushing their students to come up with a research and have it published at the end of the year. So it is actually a requirement for a graduate, as a postgraduate student, to come up with their research at least one per semester and let it publish, let it presented in a certain conference. That's why this is a good opportunity for me to join this conference. Thank you, FAU. And then with regards to the CMO mentioned by Sir Mon a while ago, yeah, I agree with that and I second the motion with that one. That CHED is really encouraging universities to really indulge with research. Now, pertaining to DepEd, hiring guidelines. Before, if I am not mistaken, research doesn't have any bearing. But come 2021 hiring guidelines of DepEd, I think there is already a part in which research will take place. So there is already a part in the hiring guidelines in which there is already a part where research or the applicant must have a research project or a research conducted. So, well, in our part, I came from Calabarzon, and Yusek Dads, when he was still the regional director, he really encouraged his teachers to indulge with research. So that is a good opportunity for us Calabarzon teachers to go or to have research publication and conferences. So he really encourages his teacher back from the classroom to share, to present, and he even conducted or organized different researches from regional level to international level of conferences so that the Calabarzon teachers, and encourage all the teachers from the Philippines to join these researches so that publication and then joining the conferences will be experienced by these particular teachers. So this is really timely for our teachers, for our research endeavors, research enthusiasts to indulge with research, because I guess in the near future, research will be part of our academe, our cycle, I guess. So, and aside from that, as a researcher also, I really find joy, fulfillment, conducting a research and presenting it to the big crowd. Thank you.
Actually, I can relate, ma'am, because at the moment, I'm also taking my PhD in a university. And one of the requirements before you can start your dissertation is publication in a Scopus Index journal. And considering publishing that kind of journal is not that easy. It really takes time. Exactly. So it's really a challenge. But still, it's a challenge, and it challenges us to develop more our skills when it comes to research. Thank you so much, Ma'am Donna.
Thank you very much.
Okay. How about the others? Still, we are in the research status or research culture of your university or institution. Or maybe you can start inserting different challenges you encounter in that university when it comes to research, and maybe share some of the ways you address those challenges. Anyone? Please feel free to unmute. Or maybe let's call someone. Okay.
Sir Greg?
Yes, ma'am, go ahead. Ma'am Donna, yes.
Can I still share?
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
When I was a neophyte researcher, actually one of the challenge that I faced before is no one encourages me or no one supports me. As a researcher, support is really important. Actually, if you are a classroom teacher, problems are present inside the classroom. All you have to do is identify that particular problem, make it documented, do it the documentation, then prove. Do the procedure, document it, then organize it. But if there is no support, though the research is there already, but there is no support coming from the immediate head, the research will not be possible. So for me, I guess support is really important. Support from the family, from the friends, because these are the immediate people that can give you idea, that can give you information about the research that you will be conducting. Now, if you are having strategies, of course, you need your co-teachers, your immediate head, your principal, your supervisors, because these are the source of information. And of course, your pupils or your students. Now, that is one. The first one, I guess, is support. Another one, it's the initiative. The initiative, the determination, and courage to face the different challenges when you are conducting research. So if you surpass, or if you are really determined to have or conduct, if you are really determined to conduct this particular topic, this particular research, actually you can start it with a CI, continuous improvement. From the CI, the output of the CI, the CIP, can be a research. And then, if not a research, it can be also innovation. But then again, we should have initiative within the researcher or within the person. So I guess that is the very initial or the important factor that we should, as a researcher, we should have the initiative, the determination, and the support coming from the people around. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Support and initiative. Those are actually very important factors to encourage or motivate faculty members to conduct research. I can still remember during my first time to, because when you say conducting research, it's not easy. It's very time consuming. It consumes so much of your time. And considering you have a full-time job, it's really challenging. But with the support of your immediate head, or maybe the university or your institution, and your willingness to really endure to complete it, I think it's possible. And during my first, in my case, when I was still starting to conduct research, I started to present it in a conference, and I was very nervous. Although it was a collaborative research, and I was just assigned in presenting the methodology, I was very nervous because it was my first time. But after my presentation, I started to wish for. It's actually very addicting conducting and presenting research is actually addicting, because it will take you to different places. Because of research, I presented in Korea, South Korea, Cambodia, Hong Kong, different countries in Asia. At first, it might be challenging, but once you start it and you can feel the fulfillment, it's actually very addicting. Okay, I just shared. How about the others? Current status of your university or institution, challenges. Yes, Sir Dennis, go ahead. Your acknowledge po.
Lang po ng konti. Kasi sa basic education po, particularly sa DepEd, so meron po kami tinatawag na BERF, or Basic Education Research Fund, na nauutilize po for the research. But then ang common problems na as a researcher po na encounter ko ay yung funding, mahirap siyang makuha kasi may mga process na kailangan. So din kaya nangyayari po sa akin particularly, sariling fund po yung aking inilalabas para doon sa mga kinukonduct kong research. Kasi napakahirap po talagang kumuha ng funding. Just like pag ikaw po'y gumawa ng according dun sa DepEd order na ito, it is DepEd order number 50. Wait po ha, titignan ako. So from DepEd order number 43, series of 2015, so that is the revised guidelines para sa Basic Education Research Fund, na pag ikaw po'y nag-conduct ng research na sa school-based research, so maaari ka pong mag-grant ng nasa 30,000 maximum, 30,000 pesos. Pero kung halimbawa po'y regional, sa pwede pong mag-grant ka ng nasa 100,000 plus. And for the national, pwede po hanggang 500,000. Na depende po sa output, depende po sa range ng iyong research. So basically ang problems nga po ay yun, sa hirap pong makakuha ng slot, no. Actually marami naman pong pera talaga ang DepEd when it comes to research, kasi lahat naman po ng ginagawa namin sa DepEd ay research based, kasi hindi naman kami pwedeng mag-conduct ng isang activity na hindi naman naging walang pinagbasehan. Kagaya po nung kinondak namin dito sa aming paaralan, so that is yung ipresent ko po sa Friday, it is relative to the self-learning module, the experiences of the parents dun sa learning modules na pinagagawa sa amin ng DepEd o dun sa pinasasagutan sa bata. So dun po ay from the research, ang output na ginawa po namin is to conduct parent orientation following the protocols na binibigay sa atin o na ibinaba sa atin ng IATF. So yun po, share ko lang po yun.
Pero I'm just curious, sir, what makes it difficult to get funding?
Commonly po ay kami, pinagpapasa po kami sa division office. Sorry po sa mga taga-division office. And then the division office will approve your proposal. Mm-hmm. So kung may pababago, babaguhin po ni teacher at ibabalik po ulit sa school. Yung time po kasi ang nagiging problema pag minsan, kasi nga po ay medyo matagal po. Syempre pag nagbulto po yung pagpapadala ng research sa isa sa division office, commonly nagiging problems po ay yung pagbalik, kasi nga po ay napakatagal. So medyo malayo po yung school na pinagtuturuan, syempre kung ilang araw pa, ilang linggo pa bago uli namin makuha. So may duration lang po kasi yung
so time is one of the challenges. Safe ba na sabihin na natitingga siya, parang ganyan?
Hindi naman natin sabihin na natitingga. Kumbaga po ay yung may factor yung tawag dito, yung may factor yung pag-approve.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Or just in case you are to suggest on how to improve the process, ano po kayo masasuggest mo, sir?
Sa actually sa amin, sa district naman po namin, Gumaca West District, kami po talaga ay willing to have research. Kami po talaga ay willing na gumawa ng research pag meron po kaming narinig na ay may funding sa ganun ganyan. So kami po nagsusulit. Ano po? So hindi ko naman sinasabing wala kami kami po ay nagsusulit yung aming distrito. At least ay may representative ng district namin. But then nga po ang nangyayari nga po ay medyo minsan nadi-decline, minsan tinatamad na si researcher. So may factor din naman si researcher, kasi pag minsan pag may pinare-revise si researcher, tinatamad na. So may factor din po sa bahagi ng researcher. So ang suggestion ko lang po siguro ay medyo huwag kahigpitan yung research. Okay lang yung ETA, pero yung sa funding, kasi nakita po namin nung last attend ko ng CBER, natuwa po ako doon sa isang province na napakadami nilang research, samantalang kami kakaunti lang yung aming division. That is true naman po. Nung umattend kami ng last CBER, talagang yung isang province Diyos ko, halos ay ang dami ng participants nila. Kasi, syempre, ang teacher naman maraming ginagastusan. Buti po, halimbawa, kung kahit ngayon single, maraming ginagastusan. Sana, sa mga susunod na panahon, in policy making ng sa guidelines na gagawin, mag-grant naman po sana yung mga willing talaga na tapusin yung research. Kasi hindi naman yun para sa sarili namin, kundi para naman sa school improvement as well as makapag-ambag kami ng knowledge dun sa existing na meron tayo. And para rin yung practice, yung research culture ay maging strong, not only in the school but also in the whole community, education community. That's all po.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Dennis, for sharing. How about the others? Do you have the same experience? And how do you deal with it? Or what might be your suggestion, just in case it also happens to you?
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Sir Greg, I'm Candelaria Santos from DepEd Manila.
Hello, ma'am. Go ahead po.
So I'd like to share my experiences. Since I am new in DepEd Manila, I am just teaching for 5 years, so running to my sixth year. I just observed that as a master teacher, I am also a master teacher. I am teaching in senior high school, particularly handling Filipino subjects and contemporary arts. No, pagka kasi grade 12 na, second sem, wala nang Filipino subjects ang naituturo yung Filipino teachers. Kasi ang Filipino subjects ay hanggang tatlo lang, grade 11 hanggang grade 12 per sem. So we tend to teach other subjects. No? As a master teacher, conducting a research is part of our IPCRF. But the problem is, not all master teachers conduct their researches. The main reasons are, first, yung sinabi kanina nung ilang kasamahan ko sa DepEd, fund, no? Financial. Kasi we tend to shoulder all the finances that we are going to spend if we are going to conduct or pursue a particular research. Like in my case, it is my personal determination na lang, personal initiative to conduct a research. So pagka ganoon meron kang determination to engage in research, and do you really believe in research, and as a teacher na talagang do we really need to conduct research to solve problems in our classrooms? Talagang determination mo na lang, no, to engage in any kind of research. So katulad sa kaso ko, meron na akong isang poster pa lang yon. This was done when I was in St. Paul University, Quezon City. So napublish ito sa review journal lang kasi Filipino yung language. Tapos itong recently, 2018 and 2019, meron akong national paper presentation. I never did submitted any research paper for publication. Medyo takot pa ako. But ngayon, thank you sa opportunity nyo, medyo tinapangan ko na yung loob ko. Natanggap naman yung aking paper. So tomorrow I'm going to present my paper. Actually, this is my dissertation paper. So part of my dissertation paper. So I'm going to present tomorrow. And I submitted it for publication. But I don't know yet kung pasado ba o tanggap ba o hindi. So yun lang, sir. Ako kasi, I taught already from elementary to college. But since nagkaroon kami ng problema ng 2013 dahil sa pagtanggal ng Pilipino, so na-force ako to apply sa public. Kaya 6 years pa lang ako, though I am teaching already 29 years, no, Pilipino. So na-force ako. But when I am in college teaching, talagang we were parang forced na rin eh. Kasi part of our evaluation, particularly when I was in St. Paul, part of our evaluation, masisiro ka kasi doon sa aspect na yon kapag wala kang research. So the tendency of the teacher, the professor, is to conduct a research kahit na i-shoulder mo sarili mo expenses. The same thing with DepEd. Here in DepEd Manila, I am teaching DepEd Manila. So because I am grounded already with research, and I do believe the power of research, no, in teaching, so nagkakaroon na ako ng sariling inisyatibo. So sa school na pinagtuturuan ko, we are 20 master teachers, no, sa senior high, sa school na pinagtuturuan ko sa District 5. But nobody engaged in research. I think I am the only one. But sa assessment ko, parang ako lang yung parang nag-engage sa research. Meron pang isa na PE na nagbublum din kasi medyo nag-aaral siya ng kanyang PhD, kaya yung kanyang background sa graduate studies, sa graduate school, yun ang nagpupush sa kanya para mag-research. Pero yung sasabihin mo na coming from the initiative of the teachers, though alam natin maraming problema sa public schools, but we never engage in conducting a research. At saka kahit this is part of our evaluation, our IPCRF, nagtataka ako bakit hindi pa rin nag-re-research yung mga master teachers. Kumbaga, bumabawi na lang yung iba sa points kasi hindi kami pwedeng makakuha ng below very satisfactory result sa aming evaluation, sa aming IPCRF. So, ang ginagawa ng ibang master teachers, bumabawi sa ibang area. Kasi yung research ay part talaga ng evaluation namin. So, pag wala kang research, zero ka doon. So, sa part ko, ayokong masiro. Kaya, I took the personal initiative to engage, to go back. Actually, I am already a researcher when I was in university. Nawala lang ako nung nag-DepEd Manila ako sa dami ng paperworks namin. So medyo ang issue din ng mga teacher, ng challenges ng teacher researcher, napapagod. Dahil dyan, at tapos yung pera. So dahil dyan, gustuhin mong mag-research, umaayaw na. So these are the challenges na nakakapanghinayang na these teachers must be encouraged, no, to engage in research. But sad to say, medyo yung iba na nasa research na, nawawala ng gana, and yung iba na gustong pumasok, natatakot dahil sa expenses at doon sa oras na ibibigay. So that's all, Sir Greg.
From that experience, ma'am, what something important did you learn or did you realize which you may share, most especially to beginner researchers in this group?
Yes, thank you. I am pursuing research because of the personal or professional growth, no? Continuing education para sa akin. Kasi when you are doing research, you will learn a lot of things, no? Though I am teaching Filipino, but since I am a research advocate, so I learned to shift, no, from just knowing the Filipino language to using the other language, English, and most probably, and hopefully, I am planning to embark to another language, no? So I'm planning to study international language, no? So ang gusto ko lang sabihin, sir, determination, no? Personal determination. If you want professional growth, if you want a continuous education, continuous growth para sa sarili mo as a teacher, you need to do research. Kasi you need to do something. kasi hindi ang opportunities hindi yan lalapit sa iyo. So ikaw yung hahanap ng mga bagay na ito na makapagpapaunlad ng sarili mo. At research ang isa sa magagandang pagkakataon na yon to improve yourself. Kasi sir, kakalawangin ka bilang teacher if you will not embark to another area or to another endeavor sa buhay mo. So kaya ako, kahit nahihirapan ako, kasi may hawak din akong teachers, no? As master teachers kasi we are handling teachers, no? Mga T3, T1, T2 yan. So we are handling these teachers. But if you are determined to grow, no? To continuously grow as a teacher and as a researcher, kailangan mo talagang i-sacrifice ang finances mo, oras mo, lalo na kung pamilyado kang tao. So, maraming kang isasakripisyo. And doing a research is very satisfying sa experience ko. At patuloy akong mag-research. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, sir, first time ko itong mag-join sa international conference, sa presentation. Sabi ko nga, tanggalin mo lang yung takot mo. Kasi yung maraming natatakot sa research, maraming natatakot. Particularly sa mga basic ed teachers, no? Takot kasi mahirap daw. At saka expert na yung mga nandiyang makakaharap mo. Yung mga ganong bang issue. Pero kailangan mong harapin yung mga takot na yun eh. Part yun ng growth na gusto mo, na hinahanap mo. That's also great.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Having the right attitude and motivation are really important factors for us to really continue conducting researches in spite of those challenges. Let's have more. Some challenges you've encountered in conducting research, and maybe give some suggestions or maybe share how you dealt with those challenges. Anyone, feel free to unmute.
Sir Greg?
Yes, Sir Mon, go ahead.
Yes. Sir Greg, I think I can say something about the binary movement in research.
Binary movement. Like
quantitative versus qualitative studies. Mm-hmm. So in some universities, in some state universities, talaga, you can still see like, I'm so sorry if I'll use this term again, prehistoric professors teaching thesis writing, and they will force students to do quantitative analysis because for these professors, they believe that numbers don't lie and opinions do. So quantitative analysis, even though the approach should be qualitative because not everything can be discussed by numbers and through numbers. See, that's the problem with some state universities. Like other students, they would want to do qualitative studies, but because these professors, like prehistoric professors, they don't know anything about qualitative studies, they will force students to do quantitative. The IPO, the input process output paradigm, because they don't know the paradigm that we use in qualitative studies. That's another problem, Sir Greg.
Actually, I agree. Because many of us still believe that quantitative studies are more reliable, more objective. But is there really an objective study? Because by the fact that you've chosen a specific topic, that's already your bias. Whether quality or quanti, it's not a matter of bias anymore. I think it's rigor. Whether quality or quantity, whenever you claim something, it must be supported by fact. Yeah. That's That's one issue regarding regarding research. How about the others? Any opinion about this issue raised by Sir Mon regarding qualitative and quantitative research? Do you still have that sir? Kind of notion in your university? Yes, yes, ma'am.
Permission
Vivian,
to
go
speak,
ahead.
Sir. Yes, yes sir. I agree with Sir Mon because maybe practically and technically, not all people, majority of researchers are not trained to do qualitative research. It's difficult to have it because the data analysis is different. Unlike for quanti, you just do statistics, interpret it, place it in table, interpret and discuss. And it's unfortunate that in most graduate school, undergraduate and graduate schools, qualitative is not really being taught that well. And we really lack teachers to really put into the kind of criteria on how this qualitative research really has to be done rightfully. So kasi po ako, my degree is anthropology. So we were trained to have qualitative research. And it's unfortunate na yung iba nga po, like when I do advising, may mga panelists na ayaw practically because they don't understand the worth and the worth of qualitative research. It's coming from looking at the context that it's just opinionated and very subjective. Well, in fact, if you do the right data analysis, the right technique, and it's worth enough to gather and provide substantial conclusions. So siguro po, the thing is, we lack training on qualitative research. That's why majority of panelists or some researchers or reviewers, even peer reviewers, would find it hard to critique qualitative research. Thank you, sir.
Actually, I agree with you, ma'am, because at the moment, we don't have BS Ed major in research. So those professors or teachers assigned to teach research just teach the subject based on their own experiences. Experiences in writing their undergraduate thesis or master's thesis or maybe based on self-study. Okay, why not FEU kaya, sir, no? Sir Angelo, mag-create ng course, for example, BS Ed major in research?
And, sir, may though? I? And qualitative. Okay, kasi kulang ang we really lack trainers for qualitative research. So maybe a subject for that, okay, a course for that specifically. If we have course for statistics, we might as well offer or have a part of what we call data analysis for qualitative research. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Vivian. How about the others? Related to that issue.
Sir Greg?
Yes, ma'am, go ahead. Ma'am Milagros, Dr. Yes. Milagros.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Milagros Garcia. I teach at MLQ Senior High School, Manila. I also am studying, taking my postgraduate here at FEU, and I have this present subject, E360, that's qualitative research. So meron po tayong qualitative research sa EDD, LLE. And at present, we are working on a qualitative research on Filipino cultural values emerging during COVID pandemic. Mm-hmm. Ayoko na po sanang mag-share kasi meron nakalagay na pangalan doong doctor. But I would like to inspire everyone na this is my second doctorate. The first one is majored in administration and supervision. And now I'm taking up EDD again, but majoring language and literature education. So pag English major ka, qualitative dapat. Hindi tayo magaling sa quanti. But of course, we know how. But we are more expert on qualitative research. So I just would like to inspire everyone that we really never stop. Tama yung sabi ni Ma'am Titular, that we should always push on professional development, push on, kakalawangin if you'll not push on. It's true. Kasi I was thinking, it's really hard, especially these times, to work online, study online, but what shall I do? if I am not studying and working on researches, what shall I do with my time? So although it's difficult, I still would still have the same problem of presenting this research again. Tomorrow, room 2 ETI 221 to 240, we will be presenting our research entitled Students' Perspective Towards Peer Tutorial Learning, a Service Learning Approach Using Online Platform. It's a group output, and Dennis Sambat, my friend, is presenting, but we will also be there. So share ko lang po, Sir Gregorio. Thank you po.
And we must commend everyone, considering the pandemic we have, you still endured or tried your very best to complete your research. And tomorrow, you will be presenting them. So congratulations.
Yes, sir. Advance. Wala pong magawa eh.
But I'm curious, considering this pandemic we have lots of challenges when it comes to data gathering. Can you please share some of your experiences or maybe the tools you've used in gathering data?
I'm still speaking, sir. Okay po.
Sige po. Go ahead, ma'am.
Sa quality po, qualitative research po namin, we do interview. No matter how hard it is, we still try to interview people. We have age bracket and we try to talk to them through Messenger or any platform where we can observe, record. It has to be recorded. And then we have to transcribe and present our codes and themes from the interview that we have with our respondents. As for our quanti, our research to be presented tomorrow, we have Google Forms. We have Google Links, and then we ask them to work online using Google Forms. And nakakaraos naman po, awa ng Diyos. And when it comes to Google Forms, mabilis lang po ang interpretation. May response, may result. Sa ano lang po talaga mahirap sa online interview. Sometimes people would not like to be recorded. Sometimes, yeah, it's hard to transcribe everything, lalo na nag-chop-chop. Mm-hmm. But still, if you really love what you're doing, if you really love what you're finishing or your goal, then there's no hindering you're achieving your success. So go pa lang, go lang nang go tayo. Walang tukuan. Sige po, thanks.
Thank you so much, Doc. Okay, how about the others? Can you share some of your experiences? So, Dr. Milagros shared how she gathered data through technology. How about the others? What were your experiences? Or maybe you can share some of your journey. Is it okay to call someone?
Hello po, again.
Yes, sir. Go ahead po.
Actually po, this is my first time to do qualitative research. Mm-hmm. Yes, at medyo totoo yung sinabi ni Doc Milagros ni Ma'am Vivian kanina na medyo talagang kakaiba siya kasi sa lahat ng mga research conferences po na inattendan ko, most ang aking pong ni-present is quantitative. So this time, so I am nagpapasalamat ako kasi napili po yung aking paper. Aming paper actually, that is the paper of me and my school head na ipipresent sa isang international forum, no, na qualitative pa siya. So, ang mahirap lang po sa experience ko ay yung transcription. So, totoo, sobrang hirap po ng transcription. As well as the triangulation part of the response of the... Actually, pag sa qualitative po, ang tawag po natin is not respondent daw. So that is informant.
Informants.
Opo. So napakahirap po, lalo na po yun na nung mga time na nag-interview kami. So that is during nung bagyuhan talaga. Kaya medyo talagang kakaiba yung experience namin dito ng aking school head. That's all po.
Thank you so much, Sir Dennis. Maybe let's have another one before we proceed.
Hi, can I share, sir?
Yes, sir, Giovanni.
Yes,
go ahead, sir.
Sir. I also agree with the idea of the you know, the challenges when it comes to the transcription. It's like you're gonna spend 24 hours for, you know, 2 or 3 days just to finish everything. Because in my data kasi is I interviewed by a Thinkalot protocol just to investigate the responses of the students when it comes to, you know, problem solving. And then I interviewed 35 students, and each student I interviewed them for like 35 minutes each. So I really spent 2 days without sleep for that. But it's really helpful because you will get a lot of data, a lot of findings in qualitative. And it's, for me, qualitative is one of the best, or, you know, from in a pragmatic perspective, if you want to move from qualitative to quantitative, to know what is to be measured. So yun na po, sir.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Gio. Wala na po ba? Before we proceed with the next question. Okay. At the moment, what is your research direction? Or maybe aside from your ongoing researches or the studies you will present tomorrow, what still are you planning to, what study do you plan to conduct? From here, maybe we can, other participants may listen to you, and from there they can decide if you are the right person for them to collaborate with. So maybe later after this engagement, some may work in group research, okay? Or some may be working on some scholarly endeavors. Anyone?
Can I share, sir?
Yes, sir, okay. Gio. Go ahead.
I'm in, because I have my university research here in my school, which is University of Mindanao in Tama City. Mm-hmm. One of my focus is more on designing an assessment system, which is deviating from the classical methods of measurement. I've been using different kinds of analysis, like the Bayesian networks, mm-hmm. in developing a problem space when solving problems. It's very helpful in you know, setting the enacted assessment outcomes. Aside from getting the idea of the formative assessment instruction, and what we really need right now is more on kanang more on prototyping or developing the assessment tasks, which is we can get more data about it. One of my focus right now is yun. And hoping that someone can make the idea of doing an algorithm to put that in our from the LMS down to the, it's like a program, mm-hmm. that when you have the data, you will just put the data there, and once you have the data, it will analyze itself, knowing from the principles of modern measurement system. So, yun ang process ko, sir. And I'm also doing detailed research on how to craft solutions-based assessment outcomes. Aside from the outcomes-based assessment, because when you say outcomes, kasi, yeah, it's outcomes. It's very well established by SPADI, which has been using in different universities, big universities. But what can we focus more is on how can we make a solutions-based assessment to justify the outcome. So, yun, sir. That's one of my ideas. Yun, sir.
By the way, sir, have you already uploaded your, or typed your details in Padlet? By the way, I sent a link in the comments section. It's called Padlet, where you can post comments or maybe type your contact details. Or you can also upload your business card. So just in case other participants are interested in your research direction, they can contact you for possible collaboration. And also, we may use those details to invite you and in some scholarly engagement in FPU in the future. Baka pwede namin kayong invite na panel sa thesis defense ng students namin, or maybe
yes,
speakers in some of our activities or programs, or pwede rin namin kayong invite in our own classes to talk about certain topics related to your expertise.
Yes, sir. Because what I can see in the issue, in big universities, as I said, is more on arguing the outcomes based, education, and it's very dynamic in discussion. Like some professors would agree with the outcomes based assessment, and it's even used net accreditation. And I think one thing that we can strongly justify the outcomes based assessment is to make sure that we have a rigid assessment system in the formative. That's why I'm proposing the solutions-based assessment through developing learning or assessment system with the use of modern measurement system. Because one weakness I can point out is we use classical methods of measurement.
Because assessment is really a very important determining factor.
Yes,
if the objectives or goals of a particular course,
especially in describing the students,
were achieved. Thank you so much, Sir Gio. Let's have more sharings about your research direction.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ian, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. This is now your chance to share your research direction, and as other participants listen to you, they may contact you for future research collaborations. Anyone? Or maybe let's just call someone. Pakinggan nga natin si Ma'am Marie Chris. Are you here, ma'am? Okay. Balikan natin si ma'am later. How about you, Sir Dean de Ocampo? Okay. Balikan natin Sir Dean later. How about Sir Alexander Casilag? Wala na si Sir.
Sir Greg?
Yes, Ma'am Donabel, go ahead po.
Can I share?
Sure, Ma'am. Sure,
actually, on Friday, I will be presenting about problem-based PBL. I want to strengthen, or I mean, I want to, kumbaga, possible collaboration with other local or other respondents on this particular topic, siguro, because this was conducted with a private students. So I want to conduct it with the public senior high school, if they have, I'm going to compare. But I don't know if how will I do it. So I need a possible collaboration with someone in the group. And also I am thinking to indulge myself with digital humanities, since I have this subject in my linguistics, and we are actually having, digging up with the different corpora
And I want...
Hello, Ma'am Donabel.
Hi, hello. Yes, ma'am.
So you work for AIAC and you want to try your study in a public institution? Ganun ba, ma'am?
Sorry, my internet connection is actually struggling. Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, you said you wanted collaborations from public institutions.
Yes, ma'am.
So you can try my classroom if you like. It's a senior high school class. So that's also the one we use in the research presentation for tomorrow. I'll put my
that's a good one. Nice to hear that, ma'am.
Yeah.
So sure, sure, ma'am. Actually, I put my in the Padlet. I have already my. So maybe later we can. And talk.
I'll put my Facebook link.
As much as possible, PBL. Thank you, ma'am. Yes, please. Okay, sure po. Ayun po. Aside from the strengthening the PBL with the public school, also I want to try digital humanities. So you.
Okay, nawala ata si ma'am. But again, don't forget to upload your card, business card, or type your contact details in Padlet in the link I sent by comment section so we can easily contact each other for future collaborations. How about the others? Balikan natin si Doc mamaya. Ay, si Ma'am mamaya. Any future research directions? Or topics you plan to study? Feel free to unmute.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead po. Sir Vincent, Sir Vicente, go ahead po.
Yeah, actually I would just like to network po sana if ever there would be people who are interested in the study of discourse markers, especially in written compositions, because I'm still trying to network with people with at least published researches or probably maybe interest po in that subject, because I need people who can also help me with the validation of my studies for my thesis in the future. Yan lang po. If ever lang po na meron po sa inyo na interested in the study of discourse markers.
Okay, anyone?
Hello, sir.
I want to collaborate with Sir Vincent. Ma'am Charlene, go ahead po.
Actually, my master's thesis is also discourse markers in written works. Actually, it's all about discourse markers in Palangka One Act plays. It's like that was my title.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. I might have to send you po a message. But can I just confirm, did you use po framework of Bruce Fraser?
No.
Okay. I'm going to send you a message po, ma'am, so others could also talk.
Okay, okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we have Ma'am Vicente and Ma'am Charlene for collaboration. How about the others? Feel free po to share. Tayo-tayo lang naman po dito. Any future research directions or topics you plan to study? Anyone? Or can we hear it from Sir Charles Kahilig? Are you here or still with us? Or maybe let's start with let's start per subject, or let's have it per subject. Okay, maybe let's start with English. Those who teach in English and research interest in is in that interest is in that direction. Okay, anyone?
Me, sir.
Sir Vicente, go ahead, po.
I mean. Maybe others po could talk kasi already discussed yung future direction ng research ko po. Thank you.
Anyone related to English? Who would want to collaborate with Ma'am Charlene and Sir Vicente? No more. How about those who are interested in maybe Filipino?
Ako, sir, actually, I'm teaching Filipino.
Okay, so meron dito si ma'am.
But I have not yet finished done my proposal. I am just planning to write a particular research for this SEM, pero wala pang clear, wala pang malino na ano, sir.
Okay. But by the way, have you already uploaded or type your details in Padlet dun sa link?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much.
My email address, DepEd email.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Okay. How about the others? Or math siguro, meron bang gusto mag-collaborate? About sa tertiary level, who are our faculty members here who teach in the tertiary level? Maybe you can share some of your research directions, and others may just respond. Yes, Ma'am Vivian, go ahead po.
Hello po. Good afternoon. This morning, Dr. Lim talked about reimagining education, and we need to rethink what we are doing in education. And so I have this mind on having a project or a paper on academic industry linkages, which I already did. So, but it's not so extensive because it's just in the province of Batangas. So maybe one thing that I would like to work is to have it extensively done, maybe in areas where academic industry linkages are being done in colleges and universities. So how can we make our curriculum relevant to this demand? And we need to revisit what we are doing and redesign curriculum based on the demands of maybe industry and other institutions. So I'm thinking about, like, in this context, in a very extensive way.
Okay. By the way, have you already uploaded your details in the link?
Sir, I did.
Thank you so much. Those who are interested with Ma'am Vivian's research direction, feel free to contact her. Okay, let's have more. Anyone po, feel free to unmute your microphone. parang I'm interested in conducting a study about teacher cognition. Meron po bang interested dito about teacher cognition? Exploring the different beliefs or how a specific belief of a teacher affect his or her teaching practices. Parang I want to conduct a study about teacher cognition related to academic writing. Hindi pa malinaw. Hindi ko pa siya na I haven't yet conceptualized it. But parang I want to explore that particular direction. Teacher cognition related to academic writing. Because according to RRL, usually in terms of teacher cognition, ang na-explore more on grammar and very limited when it comes to academic writing. Just in case may interested on that research direction, I will upload my details in Padlet and maybe we can contact each other and collaborate.
Hello, teacher sir. Cognition
in relation to academic writing. Sir Ronan.
Hello, sir Greg. Yes, sir. That is quite interesting, sir, on my part, since I really wanted to become a head someday. I want to collaborate it with you, sir.
Ay, sige, sir. I'll contact you, Sir Ronan Kirby.
Thank you po.
Okay, thank you, Sir Ronan. How about the others? Na-share ko lang. So, yan, medyo mayroon akong ka-collaborate, Sir Ronan. By the way, Sir Ronan, from where are you? Where are you affiliated?
I am teaching here in Depth Ed Quezon po, Atimuana National.
Depth Ed Quezon. Thank you, Sir Ronan. I'll contact you. Okay, once paper is already conceptualized. The focus is already identified. Thank you, sir. About the others, possible research collaborations. Those who are teaching in college, in the tertiary level. What do you plan to study? Okay, or baka nagko-conceptualize pa. Anyway, your details are already in Padlet, okay? Feel free to contact each other just in case you are also inclined to conducting a study based on the research interest and research direction shared by other participants in this group. Wala na po bang mag-share? Okay. Next question.
I know
research is really more into pedagogy, the teaching and learning of language. Then I also partner with Doc Cheney in some of our research projects. there's actually one that I'm proposing to her. Mm-hmm. And I told her that we will discuss it after Ikome.
Oh, okay.
While I have lull moments, but my lull moment talaga ako na. While our SAR teams are preparing for their SAR for the AUNQA assessment next year, sabi ko kay Doc Chini, then that's the time for me that we can also work on. Mm. Oh, may lull moment talaga ako. Proud talaga siya. May time.
Kasi Doc Earl, yeah. nagka-ano din yan, AUN and ISO din yan si Doc Isa. Kaya ito yung lull moment niya.
Yeah, actually, wow. Epe lang yung agaw na to. But, I'd like to venture more into my research interest. And the more that I do research, actually I realize that there's more to learn about research and researching. So I'm very much open in collaborating with others in terms of the research interest. It doesn't have to be aligned with mine, but it could be aligned to other participants' research interests. I'm very much willing to learn. And I think doing research or researching is one of the best way in learning.
Okay. Thank you, Doc Isa. Okay, how about Doc Regalia? Would you like to share your research interest?
Mine is more on school management. Ang iksinong sagutin. School management.
Okay, so more on school management. Okay. Oh, by the way, I failed to read Sir Christian Alec Borja. He messaged me that he's having technical issues, so he's apologizing for not responding to us. But I will advise him that maybe he can just post whatever his comments and answers. Okay. So also, we would like to acknowledge the presence of Mr. Adrian Ginto. Hello, sir. Welcome. Sir Adrian, can you hear me? Okay. So I think he can't hear me right now. But sir, if you can hear me, maybe you can just post a call in the chat box. You can write your research interest in the chat box. And please, everyone, reminder that please don't forget to create your business card in the Padlet as well. Okay, so I think Doc Chini is ready for her course of action. Doc Chini.
Okay, ma'am, deep breath. Here we go.
Okay.
Before I proceed to my course of action, may I encourage our colleagues here in this socialization room to leave their name, institution, yes. And email address, and if you may, your contact numbers also, so we can easily exchange any information or proposals with each other. Thank you, Dr. Earl, for advancing and giving us your information.
Yes.
And okay, so here we go.
Oh, yeah.
If it's okay with everyone, here are my proposals. If it's possible, can we conduct exchange lecture? Can I ask anyone if you can voluntarily offer yourself for a free lecture? Maybe for in our institution, Dr. Earl mentioned earlier that he regularly conducts webinar. We also have one, we call it The Goals. It's a 20-minute lecture, and that's just the structure. It's just the core information that we offer for the webinar. So maybe I can encourage everybody to concretize this. If you can lay down or list down your line of expertise or maybe a topic that you can freely share. Yung walang pressure, like it's just a friendly talk. Maybe we can have it down here in our chat box.
Mm-hmm.
Sure yan, Doc Chini, walang pressure ha.
Walang pressure to. Ito yung sinasabi ni Doc Aiza na ano na ito yung ini ano to, anto, invitation na parang command. Joke lang. And I mean, na-realize ko kasi, I mean, I've been doing itong buong pandemic na to. Mm-hmm. Siguro kung may kakapalang mukha sa FEU, ako na yata isa sa pinakamakapalang mukha. Wala akong ginawa kundi mangulit ng tao to offer their time and expertise in conducting webinar. Initially, napapansin ko, they're so hesitant to share. Primarily, yung parang they feel like they're inferior or they would ask me if they're the right person or the specific person to really share about it. And remember what Joharis Window shows us or tells us, you know, it takes someone to tell us that we are expert at something or we are good at something. And we just need an opportunity to share it. And I'm sure if you really are a person who is knowledgeable at something or you've attained at a certain level of expertise or you're at that level that is far beyond being just an average, the more you know, the more you feel like you don't know something. The more you know something, the more you feel like you are inferior at something. So this is not about being expert, really. A question of being really if you're expert or not. But this is a question of how willing you are to share with others anything that you know or anything that you're expert about. So, if you're willing, maybe we can list down any possible topic that we can share. And we can probably, I think, Sir Dr. Earl and for the other institutions, what we can do is maybe we can offer also and extend to you. We call it, anong ang tawag dito? I've heard this in DepEd, yung echoing. Maybe we've had our webinars already. Yeah. In-echo. Tama ba?
Echo seminar.
Yeah, like an echo. We've probably had it. And maybe I can list it down and then maybe share it with you. Send it to your email. And if you want to have it in your institution, yung parang mala coffee talk lang, hindi ganun ka-structured para walang pressure, then we would gladly share what we can share in the department. So
I thought we will go to coffee shop, we go to Conrad Hotel, and then
that's of course, and then coffee,
and then after that, so you can come up with your program.
Correct.
Harold, when I leave the group.
LPU nga ba si sir? LPU, yes! Manila!
Yeah.
Pinakamalapit pa lang tatakbuhan natin tong LPU Manila. Sir, nag-conduct ako ng webinar one time sa LPU, pero sa senior high, with the Sir Darren Fulhensho, I forgot the full name, pero sa senior high po, LPU.
Thank you for that. Thank you for sharing. And how's the students interact with you?
Okay, very interactive naman po sila, including the faculty. They were so interactive. So, as I said, I'm keeping my words. I said, I look forward to another event with you. And I think this is what's going to happen because we're here together. Okay, so that's my first proposal. So, Sir Leroy, maybe you can also add here your institution and your number, if you may, so that you can have invitation. Since we're all at this, like in the graduate school, sometimes it's also a struggle looking for an external evaluator, a validator. We also have like language experts in the department, maybe content validator. We can do that. Maybe we can exchange with each other our contacts so that, kasi diba, honestly speaking, ang nangyayari minsan in the graduate level, kung sino lang yung mahagilap as a validator, I think everyone can agree with that. Kasi para lang matapos na yung event, you know, you just grasp or get someone na nandyan and available. So why not maximize your connection? So at least if you can, maybe you can also like reach to us and then we exchange with each other and we could possibly be validators of each other. Sirs and ma'ams, do you have publications in your institution? And maybe we can have exchange. So kami, we have AGPE. And what about in your school? I believe, and I've heard that one of the requirements to be accredited is that you should have collaborations with other institutions or linkages with other entities or organizations. Maybe you can also share with us if you have publications and let's collaborate or exchange publications. And so the final remarks here would be, when do we possibly meet up to discuss on some possible collaboration? I will not be forcing you on this, but I hope you can leave your contacts and let's just exchange information with each other. I will probably send an email, including those people that are here, mm-hmm. who have left their emails and messages para naman may makonkretize itong pag-uusap natin. That's it for me, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Chini. Okay, I would like to remind everyone who are here, please leave with us your contact number. Okay, or you may create the business card using the Padlet. Thank you. Okay, so we are also inviting you to attend our next day conference. That will be from today up to the 27th, that is a Friday. So that is November 25 today, 26th and 27th. Please feel free to attend. Okay, and I think, so this is all for today. Thank you very much, everyone, for attending. Thank you, Dr. Earl, Dr. HB, Dr. Regalia, Sir Christian, Borja, of course, Dr. Chini, and Dr. Aiza, Sir Leroy Christian, Dr. Ariel Domingo, and Dr. Sandre, and Mr. Christian Ivasco. Okay, if you have no questions, then let's call it a day. Thank you, and hope to see you. We are hoping to see you tomorrow for our conference.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, po.
Thanks, ma'am. Can we leave the platform open?
Thank you, everyone.
Until everyone has left their email address. Thank you, po.
Mm-hmm. I'll leave my email, and I'll use
yes,
my
please. FU Thank you, email. Doc.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yes, please do. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. It was a good day. Okay, and a happy conversation today. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Chini.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for moderating the event. It was really nice exchanging info with the others.
Yes. Yeah, so I hope this not ends here. We're going to see each other again and again.